this. How can we are here at Linode headquarters in Philadelphia? And today we have with us Brian Lyon. You are VP of Marketing at Linode.
Yes.
So first of all, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
If you look at Linode, you know, it's more than 16-year-old company, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you recently joined the company.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes.
Perfect. So what kind of marketing challenges that you saw at Linode? Let's talk about the challenging part mm-hmm. first, and then you'll talk about the fun part.
I mean, it's an amazing story. You have a company that's been around 16 years, has no funding, no private equity, no venture capital, no bank financing. It's a company that's grown purely organically, really on the support and the dedication from our developer community. And you just don't see a lot of companies like that anymore. In this race to grow businesses and have fast exits, it's just something that's not, it's kind of a unicorn in the marketplace right now. And just that fact got me really excited, because one of the things that really starts to twist and taint a lot of companies that are backed by venture capital and private equity is that they kind of lose focus of what their mm-hmm. main objective is, which is to serve the customer and to drive innovation. And once you start to get focused more on exiting and valuations and shareholder return and things like that, you start to lose focus on really the people you're trying to serve. And here at Linode, that's really been Chris's whole belief statement from the very beginning, is he wanted to make cloud computing affordable, simple, and accessible to drive innovation to everybody, regardless of socioeconomic status or how big of a company you are or how small of a developer you are, what hobby project you have, is how to make the power of cloud computing accessible. And it's just a really neat story. And from a marketer's perspective, it got me super excited to join the company.
Right, because as you mentioned about either venture capital is funded or public companies, who is your actual customer? The shareholders or the actual customers who you're serving? Because sometimes you make compromises with your actual customers so you can serve your mm-hmm. shareholders better.
So absolutely.
That's what happens in almost all the cases.
I've been a serial entrepreneur. I've been involved in all kinds of international companies, technology companies. And, from early, startups with 7 or 8 people to, hundreds. And one of the things that you see a lot is they end up focusing on things that are not necessarily the best if you're trying to be a customer-centric organization. A great example is customer support or customer service. Working in technology companies, this is probably one of the one thing that every executive, every board member meeting talks about, is how can we lower our costs of our customer success, customer support costs? Because it doesn't help their valuations from a technology perspective or technology company perspective. It's just, it's people costs, and they don't like that. But here at Linode, we know that to deliver a fantastic experience, to execute on our mission, is that support is a major area for us to differentiate, and an area that we want to overinvest in. And you just can't do that when you're living by those other sort of guidelines of maximizing profits, of maximizing valuation, of cutting people expenses. And for us here at Linode, we don't have those restraints. So we can do what's best for the customer.
So you mentioned support, and I learned something also that, Linode has AI and bots. You don't have real people who answer questions. Is that true?
No, we have real people that answer that's the phone. 365, 24/7. And we don't have tiers either. So every service team member is trained exactly like everybody else. We go through an extensive training program, so 6 weeks of intensive classroom training, and then you do 6 to 8 weeks of mentorship before you can even answer a phone call. And it's really exciting, because when you call a node, you're going to get a real human, and 9 times out of 10, that human, the first one that you talk to, will be able to solve your problem. So if you kind of, when you talk to Comcast or Verizon or any other kind of company, you typically get, oh, thank you very much. Oh, your problem's that? Great, I'm going to send you to somebody else. And then they say, well, your problem is this, I'm going to send you to somebody else. And you talk to 4 or 5 people over hours by the time you actually get to someone that can actually help solve your problem. And here at Linode, that doesn't happen. First person you talk to is going to answer your problem, answer your question, solve your problem.
Why do you think that support is so important? Why?
I mean, support's one of these things that is not important until you need it, right? And then when you need it and you have a bad experience, it's a disaster. Now for me, in choosing a cloud computing, cloud hosting provider or a partner, customer support is a huge factor for me because I've had to fire past cloud computing companies that I've worked with. Because when I had an issue or I had a detailed question, I called them and they just gave me the runaround. They didn't treat me, you know, like an important customer. They wanted to get off the phone as fast as possible, or they ran my ticket around and it took forever to solve, or they were just not friendly. They weren't helpful. So it's one of those things that when you need it, you want it to be great. Now, hopefully you won't need it. Like, you'll understand how to migrate your servers on your own and you won't have any service outages or any other things. But if you do need our help, or you do have a question, or you are trying to do something you've never done before, you can call us, we'll answer the phone, we'll solve your problem. We're not gonna be in a hurry to get off the call. We're not trying to hit some arbitrary, you know, process, you know, thing to save money, mm-hmm. because we don't have those restraints. Right. Because we're driven by a different, I don't even know what the right word is. And we're driven by a different goal, which is really to serve our customers and not necessarily just maximize profits.
Perfect. Also, you're operating in the cloud native world. You're also using Kubernetes, which also gives you a cloud native certification as well, as mm-hmm. Chris mentioned earlier. What plans do you have, you know, for the next 6 months? We cannot even talk about the next 5 years anymore, you know.
I know.
Technology is changing so fast. Yeah. What kind of customers do you want to serve, and who are you competing against?
Well, I mean, one of the things that is exciting for me as a marketer is, you know, the world is wide open to us. I mean, we serve over 800,000 customers worldwide. We've been doing so for the last 16 years. Now with our new Mumbai data center launching here shortly, we'll be able to serve 10 regional data centers all across the world. So it's an interesting challenge and exciting opportunity for us in terms of who are our customers and who do we want to market to. We want to continue to support the developer, hobbyist, enthusiast audience, for sure. But a lot of our developers have come up with an idea, have founded a company, have grown those companies sometimes into 50, 100, you know, 500,000 person companies. And we want to be able to continue to service them as well. So Linode is not only great for your hobby project and for, you know, launching a gaming server and things like that, but it's also great for business also. One of the things that I think held us back was some of the core functionality that we needed, like Kubernetes, like object storage, like dedicated CPU, additional data centers in key regions like Mumbai, like in Toronto, for data sovereignty issues. So those kinds of requirements have now been checked, which will allow us to be able to market and serve a wider audience, and ideally serve the same audience we've been serving, but now be able to serve them not only on their hobby project, but also at work. And as they grow with any of their projects, we'll be able to continue to service them throughout their maturity.
One of the foundation of Linode is open source technology. I was talking to Chris before that, you know, that mm-hmm. Linode will not survive without open source. And what open source has done is they have democratized a lot of technology that people could not access that. You know, there are some things which are expensive. Just take an example of machine learning, you know. Mm-hmm. All those frameworks have been democratized because TensorFlow is totally open source. So we are looking at the democratization of technologies. What is Linode doing in the space of cloud, where we are seeing, you know, vendors who are proprietizing, you know, AWS is there, GCP is there, you know, Azure is there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, this was why Chris started the company. He wanted to be able to democratize cloud computing and make it accessible really to everyone worldwide. And especially at that time, back in 2003, I mean, it was not easy to gain access to the power of cloud computing. And Chris really just flipped the whole idea on its head and was able to come up with a price to performance combination in terms of the products that we offer that allows virtually anybody worldwide. I mean, our initial plan started at $5 a month. So it's super accessible to virtually anybody, anywhere worldwide. The other thing that's really exciting is that we don't charge differently by data centers or by region. So we had a conversation the other day with our contacts in India, and, you know, they're very frustrated because Amazon's costs in India are dramatically higher than what you would pay here in the US. Now for us, Our prices are flat across every data center, and it makes our low prices and our high quality, high value, high performance services much more accessible to really anybody, anywhere.
And because of the anniversary, you're also dropping the price even further, right?
That's pretty exciting. I mean, it's just another example of where our independence shows through, and not having to worry about these profit motives. Is Chris Aker, our CEO, has believed that almost on every birthday, we've given something back to our customers. Either provided new, cheaper plans at the same performance level. We've provided additional RAM at certain price levels without raising the prices. For our 16th birthday, Chris is dropping the price of our node balancers, which are typically $20 a month, now to just $10 a month. So that's really awesome that he's doing that. And he's also leveling up our packages for our dedicated CPU service. So there was a little bit of confusion around how much storage I would get. So he's actually increasing over 200% the amount of storage you would get across every plan and dedicated CPU for no additional cost.
This is interesting because I'm a Linode customer myself, disclosure. The funny thing is that when I started using Linode 4 or 5 years ago, what I was paying back then for Microsoft Office or Mac or phone, that cost is going up. But I'm sorry, but I'm paying less to Linode because, you know, you guys are making things cheaper. And that's a fact, you know, I'm actually getting more Linode for a lower price than when I started.
Yes.
Which
yes.
actually never happens. You actually end up paying more over time.
I know.
That means one day I'll be using Linode for free.
Mm-hmm. Maybe. I think it's one of these things that because we're driven by doing what's right for our customer, we're able to, I guess, you know, provide a great product at a great price. But we're able to do so in a way that we're not trying to fool anybody. There's no secret group back here trying to figure out how to come up with super complicated pricing that's gonna have all these little hidden gotchas in the end. Our pricing is super transparent. It's totally flat. It's predictable. It's one of those things that we want to make it as easy as possible for you to, you know, fire up whatever, you know, new blog you want to do, or you're doing an indie, you know, some sort of indie gamer that you want to create a new development app on, or you're doing something you know, with some of our new GPU services and doing some machine learning or AI type of work, is that you can do that really easily, and you can do it from a stance of, I know what I'm going to pay, I know I can trust Linode, and I know that they'll stand by it from a support perspective.
Awesome. And as I said, you know, I can validate that as a customer myself, you know, because in the end, what matters is that what customer experience is. Mm-hmm. So once again, thank you so much for talking to me. And I look forward to talking to you again with next anniversary.
Thank you. Look forward to it too.